My name is Caitlin Steer. I am the wardrobe supervisor at Nashville Rep, and I was a dresser and a day worker on Broadway, excuse me, and off Broadway for about 12 years before that. Working in a wardrobe department is really exciting. There are lots of different jobs. As the wardrobe supervisor, I'm in charge of knowing what all the dressers are doing and what needs to happen throughout the show. I keep track of where actors are entering and exiting and what they're wearing and if they need to change. I figure out how long we have to do that and who's going to do it and what's coming off and what's going on. Make sure that actors and dressers feel safe when those things are happening, because often there are a lot of moving parts in a show. As a dresser, I'm responsible for taking care of the costumes and also taking care of the actor to some extent. And sometimes that means helping people change in 10 seconds or 15 seconds. And those are my favorite things to do because it's really magical and really fun.
So what are some of the challenges of being a wardrobe person or a dresser? What are some of the challenges you face?
I think the biggest challenge is that you are immediately put into an environment where you have to work with lots of different people. Mm-hmm. You're working with actors, you're working with other dressers, you're working with supervisors, stage managers, you're going to work with stage hands because they're backstage too, sound people, electricians. So you have to be flexible. And that's not always easy. You have to be kind, even when other people might not always be kind or in the best mood. And you have to do those things potentially under a lot of stress. So that can be tricky, and it takes experience and it takes practice.
So what are some of the rewards of being a wardrobe or a dresser?
My favorite reward is that you make literal actual magic happen. Like you make theatrical magic. Like if you've ever gone to see a show and at some point you've been like, how'd they do that? Yeah, you're part of that. You make it happen. It's so cool. And you're a part of a team, which I love. It's not for everybody. Some people would rather not do a group project. I get that. But you're part of a team and you're making something that for me has always been really important and really beautiful and really valuable.
Can you tell us a little bit about education or experience that someone might need to get into doing wardrobe?
I would love to. I think the best education you can get is experience. And that can come by getting involved in large or small ways. I have friends who were dressers because they moved to New York and they knocked on a door and they were there at the right time and that's how they got their start. I have friends who went to college, studied theater, got their master's degrees, then did, there are lots of different ways to do it. Get involved in theater in your school. I did so much high school theater. I did go to college. I went to Tennessee. Don't have to go to a private school or a fancy school to get a good education in theater. I have lots of friends that went to MTSU. But I did everything they would let me do. I signed up for everything. Say yes. And you will learn so, so much.
You mentioned this a little bit when you were talking about, you know, how it's good to like want to work on a team and stuff, but what other kinds of characteristics would you say are important so we know kind of what kind of students might be interested in exploring wardrobe?
I wrote this down. I'm so sorry to tell you that math is really important.
You are not the only person I've interviewed that has said that.
Didn't like math. I didn't care for math as a kid and in school. And I use it so much. from like figuring out timing to actually measuring things. I do so much algebra, you guys, and I like it. I don't use as many graphs as I thought I would, but like you have to know math. You have to have a good memory. I'm sure there are people who have found ways around this. But I think being observant and remembering things is really important. Mm-hmm. You have to be on time, like really, really on time, like early on time. It's respectful and it is the only way to get your job done. You have to manage your time well. And that was really, really hard for me mm-hmm. when I first started, just figuring out how to solve problems and what was most important. It comes with experience, but managing your time is really important. And then the other things, I think, like I said, I think sewing skills are good. I think dexterity is good, like being able to work with your hands. But most of the other things are people skills. For this job, for being a dresser, you work really closely with actors, and you work really closely with actors who are working really hard in the moment that you are with them. So being able to communicate, being able to understand if like something weird happened on stage and they're freaked out, it's not really about mm-hmm. you, just being kind in those situations. And again, that takes practice, but is so, so important. You have a job where you're helping people and you're kind of taking care of someone. So you have to have that mindset, I think.
Where can students learn more about wardrobe?
I think the best way is to go see a show or get in touch with a theater near you, like Nashville Rep. Maybe there's a community theater in your community or at your church, and find out who the wardrobe supervisor is, find out who the costume shop manager is, find out who a dresser is, or find out who the stage manager is, because the stage manager knows who everybody is.
True.
Send an email, make a phone call, and come see what we do. I would have loved to have known I could do that when I was younger. And we would love to have you. I can't speak for everyone. I love what I do. And the idea of sharing it is really fun for me. So get in touch, I think, is the best way. There are some things you can search. If you search Quick Change on YouTube, you're going to get a lot of people on America's Got Talent doing magic. That's not the same thing. But there are some videos you can search about wardrobe departments. You want to throw the word theater in there. You want to throw the word Broadway in there. And that'll give you a good idea of what we do. But call us. Come say hey.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Thank you so much, Kaitlyn, for doing this. I know this is going to be really helpful to the students.
You're welcome.